I'm going to show you how to make a map animation zoom using PowerDirector and Google Earth Pro. Let's get moving. First, we need to use Google Earth to select the locations we want to travel to. You can download and use Google Earth Pro for free, and the link's in the video description. In Google Earth Pro, the first thing that you want to do is uncheck all of these boxes over here on the left-hand side in the sidebar. Then you want to go ahead and place your cursor over the sidebar and hold down your left mouse and drag it over to get as much of the space being the map as possible. Next, we want to go to search, and you want to type in the location of the place you want to search. Select it, and then hit search. Once it's done, you want to go ahead and search on the second location that you want to go to. So you go to the search bar again, you can click in there and then do Control A to select everything and type in the next location. Once it comes up, you can click on it and then you can click on search. Now that we got the two locations in the history, we're going to use the screen recorder and PowerDirector to record the animation. So we'll go ahead and open up PowerDirector. And we're going to go to File, and then we'll go to Capture, and we're going to go to Capture from Screen, and then we're going to choose Custom. So we're just going to go ahead and select the area that actually has the map in it. So we'll just place our cursor where we want to start, hold on our left mouse button, and we'll just drag it to just select the map. Then we'll let go of our left mouse and the option to record comes up, so we can go ahead and click on record. Now, once it starts recording, we need to go to history. And the two locations that we selected will be in the history. I'm going to double click on the Alamo. Now that it's here, I'm going to wait about 3 seconds. Then I'm going to double click on AT&T Center. And I'm going to wait about 3 seconds again. And then I can go ahead and stop the recording. So I'll bring up the screen recorder and I'll go ahead and hit stop. Now I can close this out. And go back to PowerDirector, and I can close out the screen recorder here. Next thing we need to do is add the video to PowerDirector. So we're going to click on the import button. And the video is in our documents folder under Cyberlink, screen recorder, and then whatever version of the screen recorder you have. So you want to left click on the video and click on open. Then you want to drag the clip to track one. And then we're going to find the location on here where we were first zoomed into. And that's pretty good there. I'm going to go ahead and split this clip. I'm going to left click on the clip that's in the front. And I'm going to do Alt Delete. And it'll delete that and move everything over. So now we want to trim this so that we don't see the words Google Earth on the screen. So I'm going to left click on this clip. I'm going to Tools. And I'm going to go to Crop Zoom Pan. Now you can use the nodes to move things around and crop it how you want. I'm just going to go ahead and type in the parameters that I want so everything stays the same. One thing that you want to make sure that you do is keep your aspect ratio at 16:9. But other than that, you can move it however you want to. Once you have it cropped like you want, you can go ahead and click on OK. Now we want to find the spot where the zoom begins. So we're going to move this forward, and once we see the zoom, we're going to go ahead and split it here. Then we're going to move our playhead to the position where the zoom stops. And we're going to go ahead and split this clip here. Now, we don't need these to be that long in the beginning. So we're going to go ahead and trim these to be about 3 seconds. And I'm going to select trim and move all clips. And then we'll trim this down to 3 seconds as well. Now, the middle clip is where all of the movement is going to happen. If I were to go ahead and hit my space bar, you'll see this is where it moves to the next position. But it's moving kind of slow, and I want it to move faster. So I'm going to left click on it. I'm going to go to Tools. I'm going to go to Video Speed. And I'm going to go to the Speed Multiplier, and I'm going to change that to 2. And hit enter. And I'll go ahead and click on OK. Next thing we'll do is add the shape and add the text. So I'm going to move my playhead to the beginning. I'm going to go to the title room. I'm going to choose the default title. I'm going to left click, hold down my left mouse button, and drag it down to track 2. And I'm going to place my cursor at the end until I see these two arrows pointed in opposite direction. Hold on my left mouse and I'm going to trim this down so that it's the same amount of time as the first clip. Now I'm going to double click on this to open up the title designer. I'm going to double click in the text box. And my font I'm going to change to Wingdings. So now I'm going to delete everything except for the circle. Now I'm going to double click on it and I'm going to choose the color. And I'm going to choose blue. And I'll click on OK. I'm going to choose a border. And I'm going to click on the color. And I'm going to choose white. I'll click on OK. And then I want this to be kind of see-through, so I'm going to go to Object Settings. I'm going to go to Opacity. I'm going to change that to 70. Now I'm going to move this where I want it to be. So I'll place my cursor over it until I see some crosshairs. I'll hold down my left mouse. I'm going to drag this to where I want it to be. Now I'm going to go to animation. I'm going to go to in animation. And I'm going to choose zoom. Then I'm going to go to out animation. And I'm going to choose zoom. And I'm going to click on motion blur. So now I'm going to go back to object. And I want to add text to go along with this circle to tell everybody exactly where we are. So I'm going to click on the insert title. I'm going to change the font. And I'm going to use impact. And I'll type in what I wanted to say. So now I'm going to double click in the text box. I'm going to change the color and I'll choose white, click on OK. And then I'm going to change the border color. I'll double click on it and I'll select black and click on OK. I'm going to drag this, move it where I want it to be underneath this little dot. And I'm going to click on animation. And under in animation, we'll select zoom. And under out animation, we'll select zoom. And we'll make sure that motion blur is still checked. And now we're going to go ahead and click on OK. Next, we need to copy this to the third clip. So we'll right click on the title that we just created. It will select copy. We'll left click on the third clip so that our playhead goes to the beginning of that clip. Then we'll right click on track two and we'll select paste and paste and overwrite. Now we'll double click on the title and we can adjust the circle and we can adjust the text and double click in this box, change the name of the text and click on OK. And now we can play this back. Now, we making some moves. If you'd rather make an Indiana Jones map animation, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.